Yes. What was the last topic which we have done?
Twinkling of stars.
Twinkling of stars.
That was the last topic which we have done. That is twinkling of stars. We have tried to find out, we have tried to reason out that why stars twinkle, right? Even we have tried to find a reason out why stars seems to be at higher position than they actually are. And we have also discussed about the phenomena sunrise and advanced sunrise and relay sunset. Today, we are going to explain about the various phenomena. Like we are going to explain about that why sky appears blue, why we are able to see the clouds as white, and so on. But before I discuss about those phenomena, we have to understand what is meant by scattering of light. Okay, when the light travels from sun, is there any medium? When the light travels from the sun, is there any medium? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
When the light is traveling in the vacuum, is there any medium?
Yes, ma'am.
Is there the medium? When the light is traveling from the sun towards the Earth's atmosphere?
Yes, ma'am, there is the medium.
Which medium is there, Vanshika?
Ma'am, vacuum is there when the light travels from the sun to the Earth.
Vacuum means there is nothing. Medium. Listen. Is there any type of gas or any type of, when it travels in the vacuum, it does not suffer any kind of reflection or refraction, because there is, but when the sunlight travels through the Earth's atmosphere, there it encounters the different particles. In the space, when it was traveling, light do not require any medium to travel. Light can travel without any medium. So there are no particles in the vacuum where it can encounter it. But when it travels from vacuum and enter into the Earth's atmosphere, what is our atmosphere made up of?
Gases.
Yes, gases. What are the various gases which made up the Earth's atmosphere?
Nitrogen, oxygen,
nitrogen, carbon
dioxide, helium, yes. Argon.
Many more.
Yes, there are even dust particles and water droplet, water vapors also present in the atmosphere.
That's true. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let me tell you that when the light hit these particles, when the light encounters these particles, when there is interaction of light with these particles which make up our atmosphere, what happens to the light? Now let me tell you what happens to the light. When the light strikes these particles, they redirect it in different directions. They redirect it. And this redirection of light by the particles of the medium is called as scattering of light. Like that, for example, if we consider that this is the atmosphere which is made up of different particles are present in it. When the light from the sun, in the vacuum, there was no such particle to encounter, but here, when the light enters into the Earth's atmosphere, what happens? These particles, when it strikes them, they redirect it. redirect it in different directions. They change its direction. And this is what we call as scattering of light. Right? Okay? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Audible?
Yes, ma'am.
So, now, I was asking, I was saying that what is meant by scattering of light is that when the light strikes the particles which are present in the atmosphere, they redirect it in different directions. On striking these obstacles which are in the form of atoms or molecules or dust particle or the water droplet, they redirect this light, and this is what we call as, they change the direction of the light, and this is what we call as scattering of light. Right? So scattering means bouncing off. That means changing of the direction of light. Light, which is an electromagnetic radiation from the sun. While it travels in the atmosphere, is called as scattering of light. Now there is phenomena that's called as Tyndall effect. Now what is Tyndall effect? Tyndall effect means that when the beam of light, while passing through the medium, makes the path of the light visible due to scattering of light, this is what we call as Tyndall effect. You can see that in all these examples, are you able to see the path of the light? Here in this, you are able to see the path of the light. Are you able to see the path of the light in the room?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. When the light is passing through the canopy of the trees, are you able to see the path of the light?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is called as Tyndall effect. That is rendering the path of the light visible, making the path of the light visible. Why? Due to scattering of light is called as Tyndall effect. Due to scattering of light is called as Tyndall effect. So what is scattering? Scattering of light means changing, altering the path of the ray of light, altering the path of the light of electromagnetic radiations. When it strikes the particles which are present in the atmosphere, right? Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Is it clear that what is scattering? I have told you that when the light strikes the particle which are in the form of atoms, molecules, dust particles, water droplets, they will redirect, change the direction. And this is what we call as scattering of light. Okay. Now, but there are two types of particles which are present in the atmosphere. The two types of particles which are present in the atmosphere is the finer particle and the larger particle. Finer particles are the one like atoms and molecules of the gases. Which are the finer particle, Balkaran Singh? Yes, Balkaran Singh, which are the finer particles? Come on. Which are the finer particles? Come on. Is there anyone other than Balkaran? Yes, Balkaran, are you able to, am I audible to you?
gases.
Yes. Fine particles are the atoms and the molecules of whom?
Gases.
Gases which make up the atmosphere. And the larger particles are the water droplet, water particles and the dust particles. Yes, Anshnarang. Anshnarang, are you able? Which are the bigger particles? Just now I told you which are the bigger particles. Which are the larger particles?
Mam, water.
आपके बाहर बहुत ज़्यादा lag हो रही है.
What?
मैम आपके पास बहुत बहुत तेज आ रही है और लैग हो रही है. आपने माइक्रोफोन बिल्कुल मुंह के पास में रखा हुआ है, इस वजह से बहुत तेज आवाज आ रही है और लैग भी हो रही है.
I am unable to make it. What are you people saying?
Yes, your voice is clear.
My voice is clear.
मैम लैग हो रही है और मैं बहुत तेज आ रही है आपके पास.
मैम नहीं,
भरत शर्मा, माई वॉइस इज क्लियर. It is you who does not pay the attention towards what I say. I said that the larger particles are whom? Who are the larger particles? Yes, Manchika, which are the larger particles in the atmosphere?
Dust particles and the water droplets.
Yes. How girls are able to hear? It is because they are concentrating what I am saying. Boys are not paying attention, that is the main problem. Yeah, I was saying that the atmosphere comprises of two types of particle. One is the fine or the small particles and one is the bigger particle. Fine particles are the atoms or the molecules of the gases like nitrogen, oxygen and the noble gases, carbon dioxide, etc. And the bigger particles are the one which are the water droplets or the dust particles. Now, when the light will fall on these particles, when the light falls on these particles, they will behave differently. When the light falls on these particles, they will behave differently. Now, how they will behave? Let's find out. If we talk about the fine particles, which are the fine particles? Who are
gases.
The fine?
Yes, gases like nitrogen, oxygen.
Atoms and molecules. Okay. When the light strikes these particles, when the light from the sun strikes these particles, okay, what will happen? They will scatter it as per their wavelength. They will scatter it. They will redirect them, but as per their wavelength. Now, what is that? They will scatter the shorter wavelengths first. They will scatter the shorter wavelengths first. Then they will scatter the longer wavelengths. Who? The fine particles. Okay. When the light from the sun, when the electromagnetic radiations from the sun strikes the smaller particle, the smaller particle, the finer particle will scatter. You know what is, how many wavelengths are there in our in the white light, in the sunlight?
Seven.
Right, there are seven wavelengths, and the fine particle will scatter them as per the wavelength. So it means that first, they will scatter that wavelength, which is the smaller one. And then later on, they will scatter the longer wavelengths. Okay? Okay? But,
yes, ma'am.
But the bigger particle, the, like means dust particles, the bigger particle scatter the light in such a manner that the scattered light will also have all the wavelengths, right? they scatter the beam of ray of light when it strike the dust particle. But the scattered light also have 7 wavelength. But when it strike the fine particle, they scatter those wavelengths first, which is the shorter one, and then they will scatter the longer wavelengths. Okay, so that is why the sky appear blue to us. Why? Because when the light strikes these short, when the light strike the fine particle, when the light strike the fine particle, whom they will scatter first? Yes, whom they will scatter first?
Shorter wavelength.
And if we see among the table, the violet has the shorter wavelength. So it should get scattered more, isn't it? Then why do not we see the sky as violet? Why we see it as blue? The reason is that although the most of the light, most you can see that more amount of violet gets scattered even more than blue color, even more than blue wavelength. But sky appears blue to us because our eyes are not sensitive to the violet color. Our eyes cannot see, it is not visible to our eyes. If our eyes would have been visible to the violet color, which is at infinity, definitely we would have seen the color of the sky as either violet or indigo. But our eyes are not sensitive to this, that is why the sky appear blue to our eyes. Is it clear now? Fine particle, yes, of the atmosphere scatter the shorter wavelengths first. Okay, so in that manner they will scatter the blue wavelength in such a manner. That is why the sky appears blue to us. Boys, it is clear? Boys?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Manasvi, is it clear?
Yes,
Balkaran, Omkar, Tek, Anushka Rawat, because all of you have switched off your camera. No one else switched on the camera.
And my camera is on.
Who's?
My camera is also on.
Yeah, yeah. Only Rashi and Vanshika is there who have switched on their camera. Kept their camera on. Huh, even Balkaran also. But is Balkaran, is this explanation clear to you?
Yes.
That when the light will strike the fine particles, they will scatter shorter wavelengths. They will scatter shorter wavelengths first. So in that turn, violet light gets scattered most, the most among all the wavelengths. But our eyes are sensitive to the blue color only. That is why the sky appear blue to us. Early in the morning and during the sunset, the hue present in the sky is of orange color. The sky is of orange color. Why so? Or reddish brown, or reddish orange. Why so? Now let me explain. What do you mean by the sunrise and sunset? What do we mean by the sunrise and sunset? When the sun crosses the horizon, on one side it is called as sunrise. And when the sun appears above the horizon, it is called as sunrise. And when the sun goes below the horizon, it is called as
sunset and observer is somewhere in here. Okay, you can see to it that if we talk about that observer is somewhere here, when the sun is overhead, here the sun is at horizon. So you can see sun is at two different position. One is overhead, means when it is overhead means when it is perpendicular to the observer. When it is above our head, and when it is at horizon. Okay. So at what time it has to travel more distance to reach to the observer's eye? When the sun is at horizon or when the sun is overhead? The sunlight has to travel the distance to reach to the observer's eye. Where it travels more distance? When the sun is at horizon or when the sun is overhead?
When the sun is at horizon.
Okay, very good. Yes, Balkaran, you can justify from the diagram in itself that when the sun is at horizon, it has to travel maximum distance to reach to whom? It has to travel
observer's eye.
Yes, person. Observer.
Ma'am, observer.
It has to travel maximum distance to reach observer. When it is at overhead, it has to travel minimum distance. Okay. So what happens when the light has to travel more distance? So the fine particle will scatter whom first?
Ma'am, the shorter wavelength.
Shorter wavelength. Very good. It scattered the wavelengths which are shorter. So they get scattered away from the line of vision of the observer. At the time of sunrise and sunset, the rays has to travel a larger distance to reach to the observer's eye. So because of that, most of the shorter wavelengths are scattered, but they are scattered away from the line of vision. The observer cannot see them because they get scattered first. What remains till last is which wavelength?
Longer wavelength.
Yes, as you know that red color has the largest wavelength, so that is why the sky appear reddish during sunrise and sunset. Yes. Now my question to you is that have you ever traveled by the road
or have you ever seen a danger signal? Have you seen the danger signals?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Which are being fixed at those places where there is danger. Like you can see that it is fixed near power station. What is the color of the paint in which the danger signals are painted?
Red.
Red.
Red. Yes, you are very much right. It is painted in red. Why it is painted in red?
Because red has a longer wavelength, so that the person can see from a far side.
Yes.
So our eyes will be easier to notice that red signal, the danger sign.
Yes, yes, yes. Because red light gets scattered least. Okay. As red light has longer wavelength, so it will not be scattered easily. That is why it can reach to the observer's eye when even from a larger distance, even from the long distance, the observer can see that whether it is red light or whatever. Okay.
Now we are going to discuss about the why clouds appear white. why clouds appear white? You can see that why there are the white clouds, because now let me tell you, what are clouds made up of?
Water vapors.
Yes, they are. Clouds are made up of dust particles and water. When the dust particles are surrounded by the water droplets, water vapors, because water vapors are gaseous form of water, they stick to the dust particle, and this dust particle is called as nucleus. They get attached to the nucleus, which is in the form of dust particle. Now I told you that they are finer particle or the bigger particle. Just now I told you that
bigger particles.
Yes,
particles.
They are the bigger particles. So when the light from the sun strikes these bigger particle, they will scatter the light, they will change the direction of the light, they will scatter the light in such a manner that the scattered light will also have all the wavelengths. Right? The scattered light will also have all the wavelengths. That is why the clouds appear white to us. Okay. The clouds appear white to us because they are made up of just a moment.